Hello! Welcome to the Electron Microscope stream, late night edition. Feel free to say hi in the chat. Basically, I'm just going to be getting some beam time in. Nothing more to it than that. I mean, it's fun though, because I'm using an electron microscope, but the AC line voltage at my house has gone up enough that I can actually use the microscope, which is always good. The line voltage around my house fluctuates so much that it drops below the minimum 98 volts that this microscope needs occasionally after it goes to the transformer. So I'm going to fix it at some point, probably with a UPS or some other power supply that gives me some guaranteed voltage. But other than that, I am going to turn this light off. Get the camera repositioned. Always an exciting part doing this. Make sure so the camera's not super crazy hot tall. And if my singular viewer could just say something in the chat, it's always good to make sure that it's not myself watching it somewhere, because it does that sometimes, where it counts the monitor that makes sure I'm live, that makes sure that I'm live as actually a viewer. I don't think it's doing that, but always good to know. Okay, that should be pretty good positioning for the camera. I can use the microscope easily still, and you guys can still see it. Okay, so we'll go backscatter, low magnification, no zoom, brightness set, contrast set, normal, secondary electron, backscatter. Let's see here. Spot size, leave that alone. Focus, leave that alone. High voltage. Yeah, we'll start at 15 kV, that's fine. Emission current is low, set to vacuum. Vacuum for the 15 minutes. Which just ensures that I don't have any off-gassing left to do. Okay, so thinking this through, I think I am ready to go. Oh. Let's increase the exposure just a bit. A bit less, maybe it'll be easier to see. We'll see how it turns out. And let's go ahead and enable operation. Give it a second to warm up. Let the current come up to where it needs to. Give that about a minute to warm up. Okay, let's see if we got a good scan. And I'd probably increase the exposure a little bit. Make it easier for the camera to see. Okay, so you got a good scan. I'm gonna go ahead and kill another light in here. Okay, that helps some with glare. Let's see if I can reposition the camera just a bit. Here, what direction I need to move it to get rid of that glare completely. Okay, let's try that out now. There we go. Relatively little glare. That'll be good. Okay, we'll go to filament saturation. Give it a bit of contrast so we can actually get an image on screen. Ah, I had to drive contrast really far, that's weird. We need more brightness. Something's not right here. Don't know what it is, but it's something. The image is a lot darker than it should be. I'm gonna give it another 2 or 3 minutes to aunt guess, just see if that's it. The image really shouldn't have been that dark. I was giving it plenty of signal. Well, if you got any questions or comments, feel free to leave them in the chat. Let's give that another shot, see if my... Because current was also a bit high, which is suspicious. It was higher than it was earlier today. I had a bit of instability in the meter there. I'm not sure if that's just from startup or what that was, but I want to check that out. So I'm going to start at a lower accelerating voltage. Excuse me. Okay, we'll try saturating current filament there and see if I get what I expect or not. Okay, that's looking more normal. Oh, you know, it'd help if I was on secondary electron. Wow, okay, I was just in the wrong scan mode. That was kind of silly. Okay, so we're going to play a bit of a game tonight, balancing spot size and contrast, especially with a failing scintillator. But I think I'm going to be able to do it, because I've got spot size at 12 o'clock right now, and I've got good signal, and I'm only at 2 kV, which is pretty impressive. So, we will punch in a bit, refocus. Apparently focus is starting to be a little bit weird tonight, but that's okay, we can counter it. Find a really bright edge so I can go get the stigmators adjusted. Let's see, where's a good bright vertical edge? Go right there. So is that you, Brian, in the chat then, or are you watching, or? Kind of curious who's watching this late. I wasn't expecting to actually get any viewers. I thought I was just going to do a pre-recorded show. So I've definitely got a stigmator error problem, but I don't know how, I don't know, because when I go out of focus in one direction, I get kind of horizontal blurriness, and when I go out of focus in the other direction, it becomes vertical. I'm gonna kick it up a couple kV. See if that helps at all. Take it up to 15 kV. Okay, we'll saturate at 15 kV. Completely out of focus, but that's kind of to be expected when you change accelerating voltage. Okay, so at a higher voltage, I'm actually seeing a better spot to go explore. Thought I was. Guess not. Basically, I'm looking for the sharpest edge for me to go into, and I think I have found it. And it wasn't where I was expecting to go, but there's a little bit of wire I used to tie this thing on. And I think that's where I want to be. Okay, this would be a nice and easy target to focus on. So we're at 3,000 right there, which is pretty dang good. Okay, that's relatively sharp edges, and that's at 10,000, so that's really good. And but if we go to normal, we'll actually get a fairly decent image out of normal. Still slightly out of focus, but that's okay, we can adjust that. Okay, that's definitely a result right there. It's pretty in focus too. Yeah, the horizontal scarring is getting worse, but that's okay. I've got the new stigmator. It's gonna go in, or the, sorry, not the, that's what I'm going to use. I have the new scintillator, and that's gonna go in tomorrow. Maybe being a bit smaller spot size, and that will help. But smaller spot size means more in contrast, which means more noise. So it's always a delicate balancing game. Okay, but let's turn spot size up quite a bit, drop contrast, and just see what kind of image I get. No, I get an image that looks better the further back you go. Let's move around the sample a bit. Okay, I definitely got some detail here. The scintillator performance is starting to get a little bit annoying. That's just a really hard spot to focus in, I think. We'll move somewhere else. Okay, let's see if I can focus on this, or if we're going to have to bring in a bit less spot size. Oh, two people watching. Well, love it if either of you would comment in the chat. Let me know who's watching. Always like to have a discussion. Right now, I'm just trying to eke out the most performance from this microscope as I can. Just learning how to use all of its different controls. Really trying to nail that focus. I'm just trying to find the best spot on the sample to do that. Also, if either of you want to join in on a voice chat with me, I can set up a voice server in the Adafruit Industries Discord. Can have real-time two-way communication. The discussion doesn't necessarily have to be related to electron microscopes. So far, it's talked a lot about nukes recently. I need a better target. Let's just go to a different part of this sample and see if I can find something good there. Okay, this is an area with some pretty good returns in it. Gosh, the noise in the scintillators is getting worse and worse as I go. This is getting really hard to focus just because of all the noise. Can't wait for the other one to be ready. I want to check something. I'm going to do a quick electron gun alignment. Oh wow, my gun was super out of alignment. I don't know how it got like that. I thought I aligned it earlier today. That's okay. At least it tells me my returns were so low. Gosh, I must have just turned this knob randomly at some point, because that's super, super out of alignment. Gosh, what? How does this get so far out of alignment? That's weird. Well, this explains a lot, so that's good. Wow, that's helped a lot. Okay, let's... Now that I've actually got, like, resolution available to me, let's try zooming in. Our actual signal. This is worlds better. You have no idea. Wow, I've got just crazy amounts of detail now. I wonder if I was that far out of alignment the entire time. It'd be annoying if I was. So that's 20,000 right there. Thank you. Just checking all my settings over once real quick. It's a little bit hard to see them with the, how dark it is in here. Okay, that's... Try focusing a bit more. Okay, I gotta check the manual real quick, see if I'm doing something horribly wrong. I thought I had this procedure memorized, but we'll find out. Gotta, we'll turn current down for the time being, so I can read through this. Okay, so, the section of... See here, what section am I going to find the stigmators? See scan mode, contrast, spot size. Here, both controls for both of the range of plus 20 minus animators associated. It's after the specimen area of interest becomes visible. CRT, adjust the spot size. See, no, see section. Thank you. Okay, so 20. So I should just be at the 12 o'clock position. So apparently I'm doing this correctly, according to the manual. I could be oversaturating. That's a possibility I haven't thought of. I'm not checking my saturation frequently enough to really know for certain. That's an interesting thought. Yeah, I'll check to see if I'm oversaturating. Also, hello there, new or potentially returning viewer. Feel free to join in the chat. I always like to have a conversation. Just the objective aperture distance, especially fiber estimation tops. Okay, let's see if I can figure out a better way. Okay, it's telling me from section 8 to go to section 6, so let's go to section 6. Okay, electron gun alignment. You too just really love pumping in and out. Wow, that's kind of funny. Okay, I think my stream cut out there for a second. I don't know why. OBS handled it though, so that's good. No, at least I'm reconnected now. Okay, I got an idea on how to get a brighter image. Let's test this theory out. Okay, so I know I have a vacuum leak somewhere in my column Z actuation, so I try to avoid moving it. But I really want to move it right now because it will let me zoom in significantly further, I believe. So let's see here. We will go ahead and turn operate off. they don't want to do this and risk a high vacuum or a vacuum dump during operation. And if you watch the vacuum meter over there, if everything goes according to plan, it won't bounce at all. It'll stay right where it is. If everything doesn't go according to plan, it will bounce. I'll have to wait about 10 or so minutes for the chamber to be pulled back to vacuum. So we'll just take it slow. Millimeters. I think the panel's at 12 millimeters. So we'll see if I'm right. I hope I'm wrong. It's 12. Okay, that's as high as I can go. Pull back down a millimeter or so to make sure I'm not colliding, if anything. Okay, yay, my vacuum reading remains steady. That's good. Wow, YouTube Analytics is really freaking out right now. Okay. I'll give the vacuum meter a little bit more time just to make sure I don't have any potential virtual leaks, which would be very much less than desirable to have a virtual leak. And looking good. I think I'll go ahead and just give it some juice here. I'll zoom the camera back in so you all can see the screen. And then we'll turn this light off. We'll get my flashlight out. Also, hello to my potential 2 new viewers. I really have no idea how many people are watching. The YouTube analytics is just kind of going crazy right now. I think that's worse having that light than any other light. Let's just turn this one on maybe, see how that goes. That's not horrible. Let's turn this one on. That's not bad for you all seeing the screen. Okay, vacuum's good. We'll go back to emission. Current's down. We're at 15 kV, and we're good to operate. Give it a minute or two to warm up. Give it some juice. Okay. I won't oversaturate that time though, like I bet I have it in the past. Bring some contrast up. Brightness is way too low. What does it think my WDF that, why is my WDF that low? That's weird. Okay, I want to get closer to the sample. So I'm going to go ahead and go to vacuum, go ahead and shut off. Let high voltage dissipate. Okay, high voltage dissipated, go to vacuum, try to bring my stage up as much as I can. Okay, the stage is as high as it will let me go. Go back to emission, go back to check vacuum. Vacuum's still good, go to emission, enable operation. Let that steady out a bit. Okay, YouTube Analytics, you have me very, very confused. My graph just shows it alternates between two people watching and zero people watching, and I'm really confused what's going on, so. I guess if you're watching, comment? Just kind of curious if there's any, okay. Okay, let's go up to 15 kV. Give it a little bit of time, just give it a little bit of time to stabilize up there. And give it some juice. Let's see what my WDF is now. Okay, we'll try that out. That's pretty high. 0.82. Let's go for it. Give it some focus. Well, this thing casually hit 1500, which is the limit of an optical microscope. Okay, let's try this out. Let's give it some X stigmator. Need to find a more uniquely grainy part of the sample to do the stigmator adjustment on. Oh, three viewers now. Well, hello, potential new viewer. YouTube's being a bit weird with analytics, so if you could just comment, let me know if it's an actual person. That'd be great. Just curious. Okay, let's see here. Where is a good section on this sample? Stay away from this edge. I haven't had very much good luck on this edge. I need somewhere flat, but it's kind of hard to determine what's flat in an electron microscope. I think we'll go right in there. Go to rapids. Check focus. It's kind of an interesting image. That'd be good to practice with, I think. I will say this image is a lot noisier than it should be. I need something really high contrast at about 7,000 times magnification. apparently a lot to ask for. Maybe my filament wasn't properly saturated because I just got a lot more lumosity out of this thing. Starting to notice where the potential problem may lie. So I'm not sure how well you can see this, but the image is kind of condensing and expanding in different ways as I focus in and out, which is a really, really good indication that I have a stigmatism problem. My stigmators are pretty much in the middle, so this tells me that I just need to learn how to use the stigmators, and that will improve the situation significantly. This is a relatively hard microscope to adjust the stigmators on, though, so it certainly isn't making my life easy. Who cares about easy? Thank you. Wow, this is a really hard thing to adjust. I wasn't expecting it to be this hard. So I'm at 7,000 times magnification right now, which is, it's respectable. The stigmatism adjustment is just, oh my gosh, this is hard. Something stressful. Okay, I'm going to see if I can't find a grainier section to work with. You know what I should get is a, just a test card. That's just a bunch of really good patterns for correcting astigmatism. Okay, this is looking promising. Well, you know what? I have a sample that's just a whole bunch of horizontal lines. I got a kind of an IC integrated circuit that's got just a whole bunch of lines etched onto it that are perfectly spaced. Yeah, let's do that. That'll be really good. Okay, so let's drop current, go ahead and shut her down, give it a second to cool down, and then we'll go ahead and dump to atmosphere. Change out the sample. Let me get the sample ready to go. It should be relatively dust-free still. It's gonna be cool. Okay, I'm gloved up so I can handle the sample. It's pretty warm, but it'll be okay. So let's go ahead and shut out, go vacuum. Wait for this to be done actuating, because I don't want to dump air into my diffusion pump. Not because it'd burn the oil, because I'm running silicone oil, but because it would just spray oil everywhere in the microscope, and that'd be really bad. Okay, we're venting to atmosphere for the first time in a couple days. Just waiting for the door to pop open. Okay, so we'll pull this sample out. Probably spin the camera so you can see this. We'll just snap that wire. Why not? Okay, let's get this processor mounted up. Try to be quick so I can keep it dust free. Trade on collision risk. No collision risk. Okay, that's tightened. We'll go shut. Give it 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3, and we'll go operate. And now we'll get auto cycling into high vac. You can hear the tone of the pump change as it starts to go under load, starts to pump down. We'll go ahead and zoom out so you can kind of see the see the vacuum gauge. Okay, so you can see the vacuum gauge right here climbing. So just gonna, okay, we're at vacuum now, so we, I do like to wait for it to off-gas quite a bit. It, it really helps make sure I've got good, get good filament life and whatnot. So in the meantime, I'm gonna eat some potato chips. If you've got any questions in the chat or you just wanna start a conversation, now is a fantastic time to do so. My audio is gonna cut out for a second as I change my microphone battery, so. Okay, I should be back now. We will start the scan at 2:40 a.m. my time, which is Pacific time on the west coast of the United States. Also, if you want to hop in to a do a two-way voice chat with me, I can set up a voice room in the Adafruit Discord server. It's quite a bit of fun having the two-way conversations. But in the meantime, I guess we're just going to be waiting on the microscope. Okay, let's see here. So I got another 9 minutes until I'm going to turn this thing on. Okay, so I've got 7 minutes left until I'm going to go ahead and power up the scan circuitry. I just want to be sure I get my electron gun, my sample, everything, just enough time to outgas so I don't cause any damage to the microscope from running in excessive atmosphere. I'm down to 5 minutes until I go ahead and power the microscope up. 5 more minutes. Okay, so just another 2 minutes, and I'll go ahead and power the sim up, or the, well, the sim's already powered up, power the scan circuitry up. Almost time to power up. Okay, under a minute, and we'll go ahead and power this thing back up. I'll get the camera set up now, get that all aligned. Turn this light off. And get ready for power up. Okay, so checklist. Move the camera off to the side to get rid of that glare. Where's my little knee pad? Okay, magnification low, zoom low, brightness set, contrast set, preamp set, signal selector set, dual magnification off, position select, image set, image shift set, scan mode set, gamma control off, spot size set, alignment set, focus, leave it, working distance set, emission current off, stigmator set, high voltage set, vacuum is good. Set to emission. And go ahead and enable operation. Give it about a minute to warm up, and then I'll go ahead and kick the high voltage up to 15 kV, and then we'll start doing some alignment tests on the sample I have in here. I guess a limit test with the sample is a better way of putting it. Okay, go ahead and kick it up to 15. Noise from the scintillator is pretty bad. This has got me concerned. This thing might not last through the entire scan process. That's unfortunate. I got a spare scintillator though, so that's okay. Well, I mean, okay. The spare is being, it's curing right now. The conductive glue has got a cure on it for about 24 hours, so I'm probably not going to put it in until Wednesday. Unfortunate, because I really want the performance from it, but you gotta wait sometimes. Those kind of like bright horizontal streaks are the specs you see. Like, all those specs, those are noise from that scintillator not being as good as it should be. The scintillator's job is to turn the electrons that are produced inside the microscope into photons, and then those photons are picked up by something called a photomultiplier tube. And a photomultiplier tube is basically it's a really advanced single pixel of a camera that's crazy sensitive and can pretty much detect, or like, can pretty much count the number of photons that hit it. So it's a pretty cool device. In the meantime though, we'll go ahead and give it some emission current. Come up to full saturation. And see, I am way off target. That's okay though. Give it some Y up. I think you're on the right. Yeah, there we go. Okay, the chip's just starting to come onto screen. I can see I'm not rotated right. This thing takes a bit of time to move. The suspense. Okay, we're coming onto the chip now, or the actual IC, the silicon wafer. Okay, actually I need to be on one of those sides because I need to use the bonding wires as an alignment, or as a focusing guide. Okay, good. Current's starting to drop, which is what I want. So see all these horizontal lines? These are hopefully going to make it really easy to get my stigmatism pulled out of this thing. Dealing with an image this noise is really is hard. Try focusing on a bonding wire instead, see if I get any better result with that. Thank you. Okay, this is, I feel like this is stigmators still. I just don't know how to use these dang things. I'll go focus on a piece of dust. We'll see how that goes. A very round piece of dust. That's honestly somewhat surprising. Take what I can get, though. Might be a problem somewhere else in the microscope. Pain gauge, brightness, good CRT does not skip now, voltage no. Since CRT would normally bright, even the spot size control is turned fully clockwise. Especially when I think crisscross, astigmatism, ejecta lens power supply, defective. Yeah, I got some calibration stuff I should probably go through. Just check all my power supplies on the different lenses. Make sure I don't like an entire lens just not functioning. Okay, that's not it, that's not it. Done. Okay, I'm running out of ideas. This could just be ultimately a scintillator failure, but I should be able to go further than I can right now. I mean, I'm only hitting 20,000 times with an electron microscope. That's kind of ridiculous. I should be able to go way further with one of these things. Stigmators are driving me crazy. What could be wrong with this? Sorry, I'm not talking so much right now. I'm trying to work through in my head just any what could possibly be causing this noise right now, or not really noise. So that's part of it. It could just be the scintillator. I could just need to replace the scintillator, but I really don't know. The image quality is just not where it should be right now. It should be a lot better than it is. I mean, come on, it's an electron microscope. I should be able to do more than I can with an optical microscope any day of the week. We're rotating 90 degrees. Got a crazy idea. Okay, so I've got image shift during focusing, which is indicative of a certain failure that I remember reading about. Let's see here. That's all dual mag stuff. I don't need dual mag, I need just regular focusing. Oh, no, better, that's the stigmator that's causing that. This is the x-axis stigmator would be responsible for that motion. So if I set focus outside of where it should be, so there the focus generates that motion, then the correcting the stigmator should bring that back within where it is at the in-between focus point. So I need to find a balance, though, between being out of focus and still having enough definition to actually see the movement. Hey, I was right. That worked. Hello, Philip. Having lots and lots of fun trying to correct the stigmators right now. trying to invent a new way of doing things, which is always fun.
Because I have no idea why it's not working.
So, the image shift you're seeing is actually changing as I'm focusing. I don't know how well you can see the image shift, but... I need to get a good check sample for this thing. You can buy these cards that have really, really accurately etched patterns on them that have very clear and defined features on them, and you know the exact size, you know it's exactly round or exactly square. And then you can just, on it has got like every size of dot pattern you could want for alignment on all the way from an optical microscope to an electron microscope to a transmission electron microscope. And then you can even use these cards for scanning tunneling microscopes for calibration purposes. Or I gotta think of a better sample. I could do that, that kind of cross grid shape that was on the, CCS811. That'd be a really good check sample. What time is it? 3? I probably should do it tomorrow. Sample change would be 15 minutes, so that put me at 3:15, so I wouldn't be back inside till like 4. Yeah, I should probably call it here. Unless I can think of any other clever ways of doing a stigmatism alignment with the stuff I currently have in the chamber. See, like a really fine dot grid, that'd be perfect. Let's see if you've got any clever ideas, Phil. Yeah, I guess it's a physical effect. No, the focusing is actually you're adjusting voltage on these some of the primary objective magnets. Image shifting is a characteristic of a problem with the stigmators.
I can't seem to correct the problem with the stigmators is the weird bit.
Still, I mean, 10,000, that should be just nothing for one of these scopes. I mean, I should barely even need stigmators at this point. Like, operating at, like, 1,500 is cute, but that's like optical microscope range. I don't want to do that. Thank you. You know, it could just be that this piece of silicon is really poorly etched.
This is a weird story that I'll tell at a later date about why this silicon is in the shape it is, but it's not what it should be. This was supposed to be a very, very detailed, very impressive piece of engineering, and instead it turned out to be a test sample. So it's actually, there's a good chance it just doesn't actually have that detail on it. Unless it's like the bonding wires are really, really consistent. Let's just go check what backscatter shows. So the heck of it. And a pretty bad configuration of backscatter, but that's okay. Oh, I bet it's my vibration isolation table. It's got a bad spring in it, so it doesn't actually isolate very well. So there's more mechanical coupling that's going on here than should be. Okay, though. So I put the microscope into backscatter, so it's actually kind of showing me more of a spectroscopic view of it than a topological view like secondary electron does. Just kind of see what I'm getting. So that's metallic right there, and that must be the carbon tape. But the carbon tape shouldn't give me as high of returns because of lower atomic number. Let's go back to secondary. Microscope's got a guaranteed resolution of 70 angstroms, and I'm just not seeing that kind of resolution out of it yet.
I want to kick it into 30kV for a sec. Just see if that extra lumosity helps and check, see if I got any instability. No, I don't want to. I know the dielectric strength of my oil is pretty broken down. Oh no, neutron imaging is really, really cool. That's, getting the point source is hard. You need a really big accelerator to pull it off, but no, neutron imaging is awesome. Also, check out SLAC, the Stanford Linear Accelerator Laboratory, though the acronym is meaningless now, it's a national laboratory now, they don't call it that anymore. But SLAC's got basically an X-ray video machine, so they can actually drop molecules, like organic processes, like molecules performing photosynthesis through this X-ray beam line, and it's a pulsed electron, it's a coherent electron X-ray, what's the proper term for it? It's a coherent X-ray. I forget what it is, but it's basically a pulse electron source, and then sends the electrons through a alternating magnetic field to get the cyclotron radiation or the X-ray radiation off the electrons, and it does that so you get basically an X-ray laser. So very, very straight line electron or X-ray we're talking about here. Shine that through a sample that's been timed to drop through the beam line at the precisely right moment, and then as it does that, you can generate an image of this thing in a very, very high speed data acquisition setup. And when you do that, you can actually produce video of the sample undergoing whatever process you're trying to image. Yeah, no, they adapted a SLAC's old beamline into the X-ray imaging system. Thank you.
sheer volume of the noise inundations leading me to suspect scintillator. I might be trying to push this thing way too far. Yeah, I decapped the CCS 811 myself. If you go to my Twitter, there's actually quite a few photos of the CCS posted up there. I accidentally contaminated mine pretty badly, though, so I need to reorder. Okay, I'm getting kind of concerned. My filament currents are dropping pretty rapidly, which means I might be burning a filament out. We're gonna call it there. I don't like how low my filament current's getting. I want to check that, see if I see some deposition in there. Oh, also, Phil, I got all my new shop lights installed. Watch how bright it gets in here.
Yeah, unhappy cameras, right. But no, shop's a bit brighter now. Okay, let's see here. So, go ahead and shut that off. Let's check vacuum. Yeah, vacuum's still reading, just maxed out. I'm gonna go ahead and dump to air. This thing's gonna be really hard in here. Okay, make sure I get good crowbar contact. No, I don't appear to have sputtered my filament at all. Yeah, there's no deposition inside there. That's good. Actually, you know what? Let's go ahead and I'll swap this out for the CCS-811. Yeah, CCSA-11 is really, really easy to decap. It's literally just a pair of parallel cutters and you're in. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna image it tonight. I'm just gonna get the column pulled down to high vac so I can outgas overnight. Yeah, just go to media. It should be relatively close to the top. Oh, also, I had it on the last show and tell. That's the chip I had inside. Gotta figure out what I'm gonna show and show tell this week. So what do you think of the new shop lighting? A little bit of an improvement? Yeah, that's true. I'm not sure if it was the right idea to go daylight color temperature. It makes it feel like it's daytime in here. Anyways, I'm gonna start shut down. I'm not gonna end the stream quite yet, 'cause I'm gonna be out here for a bit longer, but we'll pull up the HVAC, go ahead and shut the valve.
Do a leak rate check real quick. Relatively high, but I'm pretty confident it's not a leak and just outgassing. I need to do get a dry nitrogen purge setup. That'd save a lot of time on pump down. Should make my own nitrogen, honestly.
Oh, valve's shut now, so I can go ahead and kill the roughing pump. Gotta leave the chiller running a while longer, though. Don't need the sim on anymore. I've got how many more of these lights? 5 more of these LEDs I can put up if I wanted to? I got some for my sister too though, so. I think my dad got them, but. Good Craigslist special. Okay, fella, I'm gonna share screens real quick because this is kind of funny. The YouTube analytics page is interesting. Yeah, there's a good chance it broke some wires. Look at that. This one person keeps on dropping in and out. I know it's one person because when I go to full analytics, I go to playback, that's where you joined in. And it's not somebody, it's not multiple people just joining in over and over again. It's just this one person just coming in and out, in and out, in and out. Kind of funny. Yeah, that wasn't. I decapped that thing I was in way more of a rush than I should have been when I decapped that one. It was right before show and tell, and the. Long story short, I didn't actually get a real chip from Sci-Fi, so I had to really quickly figure out an alternative to show and tell. And the CCS 811 seemed like it was the easiest to decap. I'm a bit overexposed. Aluminum printing isn't too horrible. $8 by $10 is $20. But I mean, I'd have to charge a bit more than that so I could actually start paying for some consumables here. And fund my trip out east, so. But compare that to. Regular print. I just don't know how much to charge for things like that. I mean, I feel weird asking you to pay anything, honestly, except what the print cost. I don't know. How much was it again? What size would you be interested in? $8 by $10? I'll get you. So my camera's 4x3, so you would want, so you'd actually want 9x12. I'll get you as close to 8x10 as I can, but keep it the original aspect ratio so I don't have to crop too much out. Or actually, maybe I do have to crop some out. I'll get you close to 8x10 and make it the aspect ratio of the monitors that are on the CRT. But 8x10 is around 20, so I don't know. How many do you want? I mean, like 3 or 4 or what? Two to start with? Okay. What kind of finish are you thinking? I'll send you a link to the page so you can kind of see what finishes they have. And then there's an additional $5 per for the back gain hanger. You can. Yeah, no, my camera's 4/3. I just don't remember what the aspect ratio on the actual CRT monitor is. I'm trying to remember that. No, they do all sorts of sizes. Custom sizes cost a bit more. Pack of 20 business cards is $36 for the metallic ones. Or the aluminum ones. Well, the stream just cut out there for a sec, so it's the second time it's done this tonight. That's weird. So what do you want to spend total? I can do more pictures too. I've got, you know, let's do something cool real quick. I gotta wait for this thing to cool down anyways. We are going to open up, and I have 5 of these. I'm gonna do another one of these on a live stream tomorrow. More prominently on the live stream. We are going to open up a crystal oscillator. I bet that will look really cool under the electron microscope. I bought 5 of these because they were like 80 cents a piece or something crazy like that. $50 Yeah. Yeah, do 50 each. More than willing to do 50 each. Casey's your tough little buggers. Okay. You have the mid gloss finish, float mount, four prints. I'd be surprised if I can open this thing up the first time without cracking the crystal. Oh, I just destroyed the crystal. Whoops. Well, at least I learned something, right? How not to do this? I ordered 5 of these. Well, anyways, I think my diffusion pump is likely cooled down by now. Yeah, cooled down enough. Water show's gonna go off. Phil, we'll talk more about this hopefully tomorrow. If not then Wednesday. Figure out how to arrange payment. But no, yeah, $50 is more than enough for those prints. That's for anybody watching this later. If you want to print any print at that size, at 9x12, $50, you'll have it. Well, even if, yeah. Yeah, PayPal's my friend. Anyways, I will talk to you later. And with that, I am going to end the stream.